Have you ever thought about replacing a toilet, but you were afraid that you may break it? Well, we're gonna do a test, but in order to do that, we need a toilet. There's a toilet brush, but it definitely has not been used in a while.
It'll just give us something kind of with options.
So as you can see, well, it got a little cold, but we're out in the shop now. So what we're gonna do, we've actually got our stand set up where we teach people how to mount toilets. That's what I built this for. That way you could watch them, see what they do, see how they build it, see how they position it. Now it's a little harder to do because it's built up off the ground, but the cool thing is we've got things set up so we can show you how much is too pressure to apply on a toilet that will actually cause it to break. Now, this is something I've done once. Once you do it and you go through the pain, you understand it's not worth doing again. This plumbing trick I'm fixing to show you can save you the cost of an entire toilet install. So let's jump in here and see what we can do. All right, so first of all, when you're installing a new toilet, well, you need a new wax ring. You need safety glasses. And as you see, I've already got my gloves on. I think we got bolts in there. At least it says they do. All right, so let's open up our wax ring here and see what all we got. And we do have a set of toilet bolts in here. You know, that's a good thing about these little ones. It's a complete kit, but what I don't like about them is they have the quarter inch bolts. I prefer the 5/16, but it is what it is. Now, as you can see, we've cleaned off most of the wax. There's still a little bit of buildup there, nothing major. We've got it clean around here. But what we're gonna do is take out the new wax, pull our bolts aside. I've got the nuts in there. Well, man, there's no nuts with it. Is that crazy? All right, so I've got my washers and nuts I'm gonna put on here. So what I would do if I'm a plumber sitting above it is just start tightening this up by hand and get it pulled down as far as I could. Okay, so right there, I've got both of them just snugged down a little bit. So it's always nice to have a little tool with you. And I'm just trying to snug these up just a little bit. I don't want to tighten anything up. But as you can see, it's starting to snug up just a little bit. So what we're going to do now, this one is inch pounds. So there's different increments down here in inches. So we're going 20 inch pounds, which actually converts over to 1.66 pounds. And what you do, you loosen the nut on the bottom of your torque wrench, and then you can adjust this. Then you tighten the nut back up. So we're literally setting it at, we want the zero right down at the bottom of the line, and then we tighten it up at the bottom. So we know it's right where it goes, and when you grab it and turn it, you've got a little bit of a click there. When it does that click, that's when you stop pushing. So you literally want to use your fingers. Don't take a full-blown grip like you're trying to crank it down. Take it really easy and go until you hear that click. Then if it doesn't crack, you go the other side, do it that way, then we'll inch it up a little bit. And we can adjust this up all the way from 20 to 200 inch pounds, which is actually 16.66 foot pounds. So let's go over here and play with it and find out where it breaks. Right here, we're at 90 and we've slowly come up to see what we can get. So I'm gonna loosen it up, come up 10 more inch pounds. So now we are at 100. And literally, as you can see, I've just barely got my fingers on it down here and the wrench broke loose. So I'm gonna loosen it up. Crank it up 10 more. So I'm at 110. And it broke loose right there, up 10 degrees. Tighten it up and do it again. So we're still good. I'm gonna loosen it up, turn it up. I'm gonna go ahead and go 10. I probably should stop at 5 because I know we're getting close. But right there, as we can see, okay, so I'm going up 5 degrees at a time now. I'm telling y'all, as a plumber that has set a ton of toilets, I would never tighten it down this much. By the way it feels, I'd have already quit a while back. But maybe that's why I don't break toilets. And those of y'all that tell me I'm not a machinist, I don't know what I'm doing, I'm not gonna argue with you. I'm just a plumber. But I'm trying to figure something out. I feel like I'm playing Russian roulette here. Keep waiting for it to go pop. Up, I hear it getting ready. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and take it up 5 more, but I think this is where she's gonna give weight, if it even waits. I'll tell you how tight it is. Okay, I really figured that it would break right then. So I went up 5 more, let's see what it does. We are about to max out right here. And I'm almost maxed here. Okay, so now as you see, we've come to the bigger one. And Randy says that we are set at, we're above the 10, 7 degrees, so we're at about 17 foot-pounds, which should be right where the other one was at 16.666. And it popped just about the same. So on here, since we're talking foot-pounds, we're literally gonna turn from the 7 to the 8. All right, so I'm at the 10, I'm at the 9. So we should be right at 19 foot-pounds.
I don't know if we just go till we break this.
I think that's what we do. That's what breaks. So if you're a plumber, do you ever use a torque wrench, or have you ever used one to see where toilets break? Probably not, because if you did, it means you just broke a toilet. But I will tell you this. This one, we got it way up there and it broke, but you look at the way this toilet's built, this is a lot more solid than most toilets. This at the loosest settings at about 20 inch pounds, just me sitting here filling it right here, I don't think I'd go any tighter than that. If you're a plumber, how do you do it? I like going down till it's good and tight. It doesn't wobble, the toilet doesn't move, nothing pulls up. And then maybe go just about another quarter of a turn. But I'm always listening. Do I hear any stress? Do I hear anything at all? We actually heard the porcelain something, stress cracks, whatever you want to call it, before it broke. And as you saw, we didn't even have a wrench on it when it did break. If you like what you see here, do me a favor. Hit that subscribe button and ring the bell. And if you know someone that either works around their house or is in the trade, and needs to learn more about plumbing, share this video with them so they can learn too.